And so some modern-day prophets have kind of adopted this, be critical of others in the name of the Lord, and call it prophecy. One of my favorite jokes about the prophets is, you know, this woman stands up and, "Thus says the Lord, I see thee, Margaret, saith God, and I shall repay you for your wicked deeds. Thus says the Lord, I see you, Veronica, and I know what you do in secret, and I, the Lord your God, am bringing my judgment. And I see thee, and though I forget thy name, I shall get thee as well." We know that prophets, like apostles, lay a foundation, something you can build on. And I just don't think, "I hate thy guts, saith God," is really something that you can build your future on. It makes you want to go the other way. It makes you want to quit. It's validating of the prophet, but not really very meaningful to the people who get it. And Paul said that, hey, listen, if you want to really target a gift, if you want to excel in something, excel in prophecy, because what? It is so edifying, it is so encouraging, it so builds up the body. And why would we, as Pentecostals, want to surrender such a glorious and poignant and helpful gift to the goons and the kooks who want to come and just deliver their agenda and make everybody feel like that was a lightning bolt that just coursed through the room, and I'm glad I was sitting here and not right there where it was directed? It just is out of kilter with the Scriptures. And the real prophecies of the Old Testament are, for the most part, God says, okay, well, I've still got plans for you. Not I'm finished with you. And a prophecy that makes a person feel like that's it, I'm done, I'm cooked, it's finished, that's not the ministry that I understand about the prophet. Prophecy edifies. That means it builds up. It makes me more than I was before. A prophecy exhorts. We've already talked about that. It's so encouraging that you can make it. And prophecy consoles. And I don't know how to parcel that word exactly, but to me, it's like... You know, we have in our culture a consolation prize, and I don't think it's supposed to be like a booby prize, but I do believe that the true ministry of prophecy and or the prophet is a ministry that says to people, even though you think all is lost and the race is over, know that I, the Lord your God, still have something up my sleeve. You're not finished.